killing me.
And Terry Labonte, a lot of damage to the nose of that car.
What if he tore it up?
Welcome to episode 6. Yes, you heard me. Episode 6 of the Neighborhood Fun Tear It Up Like Terry Labonte series. We did episode 4 and 5 a year ago as all the recycling's coming down, so as we take care of this recycling stuff, we're gonna head over to Ulari's and recreate what we did 3 years ago today to open up the summer, official summer season in 2019. But beforehand, we're gonna take care of this, and there's one of the modern neighbors is celebrating their 1 year anniversary, you know, and seeing her in my videos. Grace Tippens, you know, the girlfriend of one of my modern neighbors, Cameron Beal, who went to my school. We went to the same school at a different time, but I think two of us, maybe three, all three of us did. So we're gonna make a quick stop over there, wish them happy anniversary. But even though Grace can't do YouTube anymore because of her current occupation being a teacher, go subscribe to her channel, link in the description. So let's get this party started, as no transportation for the next 3 days, so we get the whole rest of the week off. So let's fucking party. Boogity, 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 bitch. I just realized they're doing the other side and not our side, so. Oh well, I'm not gonna sit here and wait and stuff free for that damn long and waste any more time. We got a couple to wish a happy anniversary to, and you know, some longtime neighbors and best friends to tear some shit up like Terry Labonte with. So let's get cracking. Okay, by the looks of it, there's no cars there. There's the garage doors closed, and yep, nobody's there. So it's gonna have to wait until tomorrow or the next. Well, tomorrow. Today is Wednesday, right? It's gonna have to wait till the next 2 or 3 days, depending on how busy we are on Friday with, you know, Villains of Valley View and Ultraviolet and Black Scorpion, and of course season 6 of Bug. So it just depends on how busy we are beforehand. But so therefore, depending on, you know, on what our status when tomorrow and the day after and how busy we are before Disney Channel Night in America Friday, I guess there'll be a few other chances later this week to wish Cameron and Grace a happy Steve Park first anniversary together. But enough of this, you know, screwing around over here and shit. Let's turn around and go back to Ulari's, where the whole main plot of this video is, you know, meant to be. All right, they're getting ours now, so we'll make one last extra stop before you take care of this shit, and we'll be on our way to the main storyline slash plot of this video. Tearing shit up like Terry Labonte with the Ulari's 3 years to the day we opened up summer when we went all fucking wild and crazy. This time the 2022 recreation will be on camera. Okay. Wait, it feels a little full. Nope, we're good. We're good. We're good. Damn lawnmower's in the fucking way. Come on. I'm sorry, guys. I mean, this episode of Fun in the Sun is off to a smashing start. Oh my god, yeah. That takes care of that. Now we can finally go to our main destination. There's our destination, but now these assholes are still in the fucking way. Come on, guys. Move your bitch ass. Finally. All right, there's Abby's car, and all the cars are there, so we're ready to fucking tear some shit up like Texas Terry Labonte and Rock and Roll Jeopardy 3 years later on this day. I have never been that angry with the goddamn garbage truck in my entire fucking life, but we've reached our destination. This is it. Let's go. Oh, shit. Who's gonna answer if this damn bee goes the fuck away? Happy anniversary! 3 years later.
Are you ready? Come out. Wait. Move.
Are you ready to? Are you ready to recreate the shit later?
No. Turn that off. Yo.
Okay. Okay, they have company over with additional family members with multiple dogs. I don't want to get the license plate, but if I got it, don't worry, I will censor it. But anyway, now us doing it is like up in the air, so Okay, so therefore, okay, I'm gonna censor all that. Don't worry, I know how to do that stuff. But if the relatives are leaves like and like in a timely manner, that means they'll probably be, you know, they don't matter. We'll be able to do it tonight. Meaning that if we see them all set up in the front, you'll know that it's our night. You know that's in our, that's all, you know it's our night. It's gonna be our night. So, for as my grandmother always say, you just gotta pray on it. So let's go find some other fun while we're playing the waiting game for the Ulares. I know I just saw Maya the other day, but since I didn't know till after the fact that it was her birthday, I didn't get a chance to tell her in person. So let's go see if she's there. This way we can actually say it to her in person. Okay, I'm sorry if I stood there, you know, for a long ass time. I really wasn't waiting for her since nobody answered the door. It was already obvious that they, just because this car is there doesn't mean they're available to talk or do stuff. So, well, I was actually, Isabella Pappas, you know, responded to my DM. And so I was actually replying back to her since it was just now. So that's why I was standing there. So I guess we'll catch up with the Halliburtons later. But anyway, let's see what else we can find and who else we can see.
One very large reunion later.
All right, so nobody answered at Halliburton's, but God, my day was just fucking made. I saw that sweet lady who used to be when she was here, my number one neighbor in all of Sandy Ridge, you know, until she moved away. Well, you'll see the proof on social media later tonight, but I just ran into Lauren Gift, who's here taking care of her sister Heidi's cat, and possibly the dog too, since they're on vacation, as you saw the video with Lucas and I. But, oh my God, that just made my day. I mean, I've been dying a long time to see her, and I knew that was her with the blonde hair as soon as I saw her, to the point where I'm speechless. I don't know what to fucking say, but I started running before I could yell for her. And then as soon as I got close, I said, Lauren, is that you? And it was her. It was her. All right. And was that Jamie that just went by? Was that Jamie? Am I hallucinating, or the people I love, I haven't seen in a long time, are chasing me down today? That looked awfully familiar to me when I saw the face go by. But wow, if that was, then nothing's gonna kill my fucking mood, bitch. Oh, mama. So something tells me this is gonna be one of those videos. All right, little Ulari check, you know, summer, first day of summer recreation check-in. Looks like that relative of theirs left. So it looks like we're gonna be good to go to reenact this shit tonight. I'm overheating out here, so it's either drink some Gatorade or eat that Mr. Hero my mom got us for dinner. So both are perfect. Wait, it's perfect that my mom got me food as I was wanted to be eating food as I was coming home, because, you know, remember how she used to bitch at me on Sandhurst saying I need to eat, and like stuff like this, saying I need to eat this, I need to eat that. And of course, I kind of bitched back because I just didn't want to listen. Well, I was like 17, 18, 19 years old back then. I was a teenager. Now that I'm older and I'm a fully grown adult, I understand now. So, you know, I just wanted to eat, you know, once I parked the bus and, you know, do all the post outdoor activity routine. So I'm just going to take a small, you know, Gatorade break. But anyway, so let's do another Cool in the Gang 2 hot clip just for shits and giggles. Boy, that Gatorade felt good. Now I'm feeling a little bit better. Okay, so where are we gonna make our, oh, look at this. Let's go check this out, like Kevin LePage. Yeah, I was talking to my friend over on the back straightaway, Megan Edie, who I haven't really talked to in a long time. I mean, the only thing we've done up until just a couple seconds ago off camera was just wave to each other as we're going on by. That's just about it. But as today, you know, catch up with people, catch up with longtime friends you haven't seen in a long time day. Seems pretty long for a holiday name, to tell the truth, like Anthony Anderson. All right, I mean, yeah, it is high. It's muy caliente. I got some company here. We got Miss Kim. Kim, right?
No, Judy.
No, Judy, I'm sorry. Why do I keep thinking? This is Miss Judy, which is Megan's mother. Mm-hmm. You know, Zane's aunt's mother.
Yeah.
I haven't seen that kid since 2020.
For a while.
And we're out for a walk. I mean, watching, you know, the little Andy and Megan's little girl, Violet, while they're out for the night.
That's right.
Yeah. I don't know why I thought your name was Kim when I turned this on.
That's okay.
Yeah. But yeah, this is Judy.
Yeah.
Judy. Do you have the same last name as Megan and Andy?
No, I don't.
What is it?
I don't want to say it.
Okay. Okay. Maybe off camera you can.
I think it's a good idea.
That's more than just a good idea. That's wise, like Dale Earnhardt Jr. You can't spell Budweiser without being wise. Do you get the joke? Because, you know, there's the word wise is in the middle of Budweiser, but except it's a different spelling. That's how I came up with the tagline, wise like Dale Earnhardt Jr. And then do you know the song You Gotta Be by Desiree?
No.
You gotta be bad, you gotta be. I called it the Dale Earnhardt Jr. song because when I heard the word, there's You Gotta Be Wiser, I would think of the Budweiser number 8. So that's how I came up with the song nickname, the Dale Earnhardt Jr. song.
Oh.
Because I have song nicknames, you know, for various reasons as to why I gave them nicknames. Like, my favorite one is the Bubba Wallace song. Because that's probably the only modern NASCAR driver I have a song nickname for. Because I made a connection to Bubba Wallace and the guy who sings it, Bubba Sparks. So because when Bubba Wallace was coming up to the NASCAR ranks back in the early to mid 2010s, that song would play rent free in my head whenever they talked about him. And so I just calling it the Bubba Wallace song out of nowhere. And then I call it the one I have for senior is Iris by the Goo Goo Dolls. I call it the Dale Earnhardt song because I remember there was the Dale Earnhardt tribute concert 2 years after he died. That was a big, because NASCAR was at peak his popularity in 2003. And they were showing like all these various clips from his career to promote that concert. There was a clip of him waving to the crowd after he won one of his championships, and they were playing the part of the Iris Goo Goo Dolls in the back, and that just stuck in my brain since I was a kid and I saw that. So that's why I call it the Dale Earnhardt song.
Okay.
Yeah. And that went well, but man, Judy wasn't wrong. It is hot as balls. Not as much as it was last week. Last week it was fucking more than hot as balls. It was Devil's fucking Canyon. Like, oh my God. I knew it was going to be a hot one today when I saw on the radar in my phone that it was going to be 94. You know, Bill Elliott, kind of, that's nothing compared to the Kurt Busch temperature last week. You know, was it the zoo when it was Kurt Busch 97? No, it was the day after when we thought it was going to rain, and yet we got full on sunshine instead. Meaning we could have celebrated Marissa Keir's birthday a day late, but look at all that stuff we would have missed on there if we didn't record that birthday tribute for her when we did. Like, you know, sometimes, you know, it's best to alternate plans for good reasons like that. Sometimes it's best to alternate plans because if you don't, you miss out on a lot of cool things that, you know, like we experienced when we recorded that birthday tribute that day. So that just goes to show you that if life has taught me anything, even before all these shows with all these life lessons came along, everything happens for a reason. And everything happens for a reason, even if it's bad. Yo, oh, look at this. Okay, I was trying to catch something cool that I said, this is what I was saying, look at this for, but it was too fucking late. I wasn't quick enough to get the camera, to flip the camera to show you, but I saw two random dudes, you know, going around the track on like little formula bike vehicles or Indy bike vehicles, open wheel bikes. It's like, goodness gracious. Only problem was they were going caution flag speed, not like full on green flag speed, going 180 some miles an hour, which would have been sick, but you know, safety first. This isn't Daytona, Talladega, or now Atlanta. Okay, here's the little update. I know Abby just left. When I was hanging out with Judy, not Kim, goddammit. That's when, you know, I saw Abby leaving, but hopefully she'll be back in time before we park the bus so we can recreate a little first day of summer 2019 little fiesta in the driveway. Brett Bodine is not rattling shit.
What?
I said Brett Bodine is not rattling shit. That was a NASCAR YouTuber by the name of Toxic Fungi 13 one time said that, playing Thunderdome 4, because they have the stupid-ass rival system. And so, therefore, he was doing Johnny Benson season mode. And so he made Brett Bodine a rival, and Brett Bodine was driving like a dick after they became rivals.
Yeah.
And so when he was pulling into pit, Toxic Fungi as Benson was pulling into pit, the crew chief says, because Brett Bodine's indicator appeared on the bottom, the crew chief said, hey, he might try to rattle your cage, and the guy playing as Benson says, Brett Bodine is not rattling shit. I used to say that all the time as a running joke because of that video. It's like funny NASCAR YouTuber that I watch all the time. Toxic Fungi 13. Because of him and Kamikaze Games, I've learned a ton of dirty terminologies and colorful words in the 2019-2020 season. Because of them. Stuff that I never said before until I started watching them all the time. I still watch a lot of Toxic Fungi, but I don't watch much Kamikaze anymore like I used to. But no matter how often you watch those guys, they are funny as hell. Especially Kamikaze. His gripe with the Dylan brothers, Noah Gregson and Riley Herbst, doesn't even faze me. Because of how funny he is and how fire his YouTube content is. Doesn't faze me at all. I mean, I'm not gonna dislike someone just because they don't like my drivers. Yeah, man, this guy's a comedian over here, Mohammed Mo Mustafa. Probably the biggest comedian you'll probably ever meet in Sandy Ridge. As he's basically Sandy Ridge's version of Rob Riggle and David A. Arnold. If you ask my dad, who's not here now, but if you ask my dad, he'll probably say he's like Bernie Mac or something. Cause my dad loved Bernie Mac before he had me.
I like Bernie Mac too.
Yeah, mine is David Arnold and Rob Riggle, because they've worked and do work on Nickelodeon.
Bernie Mac was the GOAT.
Yep. That's what I heard. My dad loved him and still does. Even though he's no longer here, my dad still like carries on his legacy. I don't pay much attention to Rob Riggle no more because that attention all went to I still love Rob Riggle, but my attention span went from him to David Arnold and spent it this year. Actually, end of last year going into this year. Because when he made That Girl Lele, I became a bigger fan. Because I was already a big fan when he was on Side Hustle as the baseball coach, which both are Nickelodeon shows. Yeah, and I didn't get to meet the guy like I wanted to at his show and at Netflix, but I did get to meet someone, his oldest daughter, Anna Grace, who's on Nickelodeon with them. Yeah, and it was her birthday like yesterday, I think. Yeah, Matt Kent at 17 years of age.
Yeah.
Okay, what?
Take a seat.
Okay. Okay. Rookie appearance on the channel is Hannah, the comedian's wife. We're back here tearing some shit up like Terry Labonte. We promise you a first day of summer shenanigan. This was not what we had in mind. Because it doesn't look like you Larry's over.
He caught me mopping.
Yeah, it doesn't look like you Larry's all set up in turn two, so we might have to do that shit with them another day. But what is what's all this craziness here? He's funny, but crazy in the good kind of crazy. La vida loco, Ricky Martin.
What'd you say? Viva la.
La vida loca, like Ricky Martin. Living la vida loca. That's a 1999 song, my favorite song, written by Robbie Draco Rosa and Desmond Child.
Where are you going?
Where do you think you're going? No, no, in the street. No.
Their father.
Yeah, but most of you guys are getting offense because he didn't like the fact that they were going towards the stream.
Yeah. Yeah, I think we are.
Go in the pool.
Yeah.
I think they're done. Yeah, because when me and my sister were kids, even though she was allowed to do more things than me, be her being older, the only thing she probably wasn't allowed to do along with me was go in the house soaking wet after we played in the water outside. Yeah. That was like the only thing we both were not allowed to do. When we lived down in Lenore, she was allowed to cross the street. I wasn't. And when I finally got old, I turned into an early teenager. I was allowed to cross the street anytime I wanted. On Lenore, that is. Even when we visited my grandparents on Sanders before my mom bought it off of them, I wasn't allowed to cross on the other side either.
Yeah.
But now then, when I turned like 13 years old, I was allowed to do that kind of stuff by then.
Yeah, because they're younger, and you know.
And my dad, when I was 13, let me watch the Rush Hour movies, even though my mom didn't want me to, and she wanted to kill him. I mean, like, why did you let him watch those movies, even though he's 13? I know it's PG-13, but come on, he's still a kid. But this is 2007 standard. I was 13 in 2007. Back then, my favorite drivers in NASCAR were Kyle Petty and rookie Juan Montoya.
I don't know any of them.
NASCAR drivers. Montoya left NASCAR at the end of 2013. Petty retired at the end of 2008 season. His last race was the 2008 Checker Auto Parts 500 at Phoenix. He kind of went out sad because he got caught up in a wreck that was where I saw a car get on top of another car.
Yes.
All right. Well, unfortunately, the little first day of summer fiesta of recreation will have to wait till the Casey Atwood installment of the Neighborhood Fun series. But Michelle and Bob got home, so let's go see them. Well, unfortunately, time ran out. So we'll see the Beals another day and maybe sometime this week, maybe tomorrow or the day after. Me and the Ularis will reenact our little... Oh my God. We'll reenact our little, you know, first day of summer madness from 3 years ago, since, you know, they weren't set up outside. But this will conclude episode 6 of the Neighborhood Fun series. Our Neighborhood Fun Teared Up Like Terry Labonte, the full name, but Neighborhood Fun for short. But hopefully if the Ularis are all set up, either tomorrow's Wednesday, or Thursday, or Friday... No, Friday, we're not going to have much time because, you know, Bunked, Villains, and Ultra. If they're set up like tomorrow or the day after, then we'll try to do something. We'll do episode 7 of Neighborhood Fun. But my phone's getting ready to die, and I do not want my family scrambling around looking for me and blowing up my phone that's about to die. So have a good night tonight and a better day tomorrow. Life will give you a lot of lows, but when you hit a high, enjoy it. It ain't for the weak. Goddamn, be you. You have to try harder to do less. You can't deport a dream. Sometimes the worst things in life lead to the best things. Always bet on the side of love. Check yourself before you wreck yourself. Sometimes you just got to be present, and you never fail until you stop trying. So take care, everyone. Good night, and I'll probably see you for the Casey Atwood installment of this series either tomorrow or Thursday, depends on who's out. But now it's time to park that motherfucking bus. So see you later, everyone.